Students, in the previous lecture, we already have learned that in case of a pure semiconductor, number of electrons and number of holes are equal. Whereas in case of extrinsic semiconductor, number of electrons and number of holes are not equal. Intrinsic semiconductors are pure semiconductor. Intrinsic semiconductors are pure semiconductors. They does not have any impurities. They are made up of germanium, silicon, arsenic, phosphorus. So such materials, they are treated as pure semiconductor. Now let us see, in case of a semiconductor, what would happen? Pure semiconductor. Pure semiconductor or intrinsic semiconductor. Now let us see, in case of pure semiconductor, there are 5 electrons, and this is valence band and this is conduction band. As we know, in case of pure semiconductor, like semiconductor at 0 Kelvin, all the electrons will be residing in valence band. There will be no electrons in conduction band. Energy band gap between this is 1 electron volt. This is energy band gap. Now at room temperature, what would happen? When temperature is equal to 300 Kelvin, if the temperature is 300 Kelvin, obviously these electrons will be shifted into, from valence band, it enter into conduction band. From valence band, all these electrons enter into conduction band. They overcome energy band gap, and all these electrons enter into conduction band. So when electrons are entering into conduction band, definitely there is a vacant space formed here. This is vacant space, this is vacant space, this is vacant space. These are vacant space in the valence band, where it is necessary to get accommodated by an electron. Now, number of electrons in conduction band is equal to some 5. I am just considering it as an example, but actually number of electrons in case of semiconductor will be in the order of 10 power 24 to 10 power 26. That is the order which we have already discussed. For simplicity, I am considering only 5 number of electrons. And now, how many number of holes are present in valence band? Number of holes in valence band is equal to 5. Therefore, in case of a pure semiconductor, what happens? All the electrons in the valence band get shifted to conduction band, resulting in number of electrons in the conduction band is equal to number of electrons in valence band. Such type of semiconductor is said to be a pure semiconductor. So when all the electrons from valence band enter into conduction band, there are no electrons in the valence band to transfer. So as no electrons are present in valence band, holes are not shifted from their positions. If there is any electron in the valence band, that electron will be shifted from one hole to the other hole, resulting in hole current in the valence band. But here, as there are no electrons in the valence band, all the holes remain as it is, holes in their own position without actual motion of the holes. Therefore, as there are no electrons present in the valence band, poles are not shifted from their position. Therefore, pole current will be equal to zero and net conduction in pure semiconductor is less. So as we know, like there is only contribution of electron current, that two electrons in the conduction band will contribute current in case of a pure semiconductor. That is the reason why net conduction is equal to conduction due to holes plus conduction due to electrons. In case of pure semiconductor, net current will be, net conduction is only because of conduction due to electrons in conduction band. Whereas conduction due to holes in the valency band will not contribute any current in case of pure semiconductor. So that is the disadvantage of a pure semiconductor. In case of a pure semiconductor, conduction is very less. Conduction is very less in case of pure semiconductor, and there are only two types of pure semiconductors. Two pure semiconductors are germanium and silicon, and this germanium and silicon, they are tetravalent. These are tetravalent pure semiconductors. And remember, this belongs to fourth group. These are fourth group elements. So usually in the periodic table, only germanium and silicon, which belongs to fourth group, are semiconductors. Of course, carbon also belongs to fourth group, but it is not treated as a semiconductor because the energy band gap for carbon is greater than 2 electron volts. That is the reason why, based on energy band gap, we are classifying the materials into semiconductors, conductors, and insulators. It is not based on the group number. So remember that all fourth group elements are not semiconductors. Only germanium and silicon are treated to be as pure semiconductors. So in case of pure semiconductor, number of electrons and number of holes are equal. That's the reason why there is a limited conduction in case of pure semiconductor. But whereas in case of, in order to increase the conductivity of a pure semiconductor, we should increase the hole number or we should increase the electron number. So therefore, in order to increase electron number or hole number, we add some impurities to the pure semiconductor. Number of electrons or holes. So we will be adding some impurities to the pure semiconductor. When we are adding some impurities to increase the number of electrons or number of holes, pure semiconductors become impure. And such impure semiconductors are also called extrinsic semiconductors. Okay. So extrinsic semiconductors are impure semiconductors because there are some impurities present, is impurities added to the pure semiconductor, right? So adding desirable number of impurities, desirable amount, not a number, amount of impurities to pure semiconductor is called doping. It is called doping. Adding impurities to a pure semiconductor is said to be as doping. You might have listened this word doping generally in athletes, like athletes and athletes participating in Olympics. They will be tested with they will be before participating in the game, they will have one dope test. In the dope test, they will check whether they are taking any drugs or not. That means like some impurities are added into their body. In order to increase the efficiency, they add some impurities. That is called dope test. Likewise, here also, a pure semiconductor, it is not having sufficient conductivity to use them practically for our daily need. Therefore, we will be taking some impurities and will add those impurities to a pure semiconductor, which results in increase in the conductivity. So therefore, adding desirable amount of impurities to a pure semiconductor is called doping. And when you are doping, there are two possibilities. Doping can be done in such a way, number of electrons can be increased or number of holes can be increased within the pure semiconductor. So there are two possibilities where by doping, if number of electrons are greater than number of holes, such semiconductor is called n-type semiconductor. N is negative. Like you can just remember it. It does not mean that it is negatively charged. You can just remember that. Now, N-type. N-type mean negative charges are greater in number. Negative, that number of electrons are greater in number in case of a N-type semiconductor. Similarly, by doping, if number of holes are made greater than that of number of electrons, such semiconductor is called p-type. P-type semiconductor, positive charges are greater in number in case of p-type semiconductor. So that is how n-type and p-type semiconductors, they are impure semiconductors. We will be constructing n-type and p-type semiconductors. Naturally, they are not found. Only germanium and silicon are pure semiconductors. Remaining all other semiconductors which we are using in our daily life, they are impure semiconductor. Using a pure semiconductor, we cannot do anything. It is not sufficient for our purpose. So we will not use pure semiconductor. Definitely, we will add some dopants, resulting in either p-type or n-type semiconductors. So extrinsic semiconductors are impure semiconductors. Practically, all the semiconductors which we are using, they are impure semiconductors only. Comparisons between intrinsic semiconductor and extrinsic semiconductor. So first comparison is based on purity of semiconductor. Based on purity of semiconductor, intrinsic semiconductors are pure, extrinsic semiconductors are impure. And based on density of the electrons, density of electrons is equal to density of holes. Whereas in extrinsic semiconductor, density of electrons is not equal to density of the holes that we have discussed. And based on electrical conductivity for a pure semiconductor is very low. Electrical conductivity of a extrinsic semiconductor is high. And effect of temperature. Intrinsic semiconductor, they are dependent on temperature. So if temperature is greater, electrons in the valency band absorb energy and all the electrons can enter into conduction band, resulting in no motion of holes in the valence band. So therefore, intrinsic semiconductor conductivity depends upon temperature only. And whereas extrinsic semiconductor depends on temperature as well, like conduction is dependent upon temperature and as well as impurity of the semiconductor. So here both factors are considered when we are explaining conductivity of extrinsic semiconductor: amount of impurities present in them and also temperature of the semiconductor. And in case of intrinsic semiconductor, these are pure, therefore they will not have any impurities. Whereas in case of extrinsic semiconductor, you can add trivalent impurities or you can add pentavalent impurities. Pentavalent impurities mean whose valency is 5. Trivalent impurity is that whose valency is 3. So that is comparison between pure semiconductor and impure semiconductor. And there is one equation you need to remember when we are dealing with electron number or concentration. We generally call it as concentration. In case of intrinsic concentration, you have this equation. Ni square is equal to A naught into T power 3 into e power minus Eg by kT, where T is temperature here. T is the temperature and A naught is some constant. Eg is energy band gap. Eg is equal to energy band gap. T is equal to temperature. A naught is constant. K is equal to Boltzmann constant. Boltzmann constant you will learn in class 11th. So K is Boltzmann constant, T is temperature. You need to remember this equation. And the fraction of electrons of valency band present in conduction band is given by this equation. Other equation which you have is this. The number of electrons present in the conduction band, out of all the electrons in the valence band, the fraction number is depending on this equation. So fraction number F is directly proportional to e power minus Eg by kT. Of course, this total parameter will be constant. The fraction is depending only on this parameter, e power minus Eg by kT. Right? So as temperature increases, the fraction number increases. Doping a pure semiconductor, as we know, in case of doping, by doping conductivity of increases. Conductivity increases by doping. And number of electrons become not equal to number of holes. Either number of holes may increase, either electron number can be increased. So therefore, total number of carrier concentration can be equal to number of holes. Total number of carrier concentration in this can be number of electrons. This become p-type. This become n-type. This we already have discussed. And at any particular time, the total number of carrier concentrations can be written as Ne into Nh, which is equal to Ni square. This is one more important equation which you should use to solve problems. Ne is number of electrons, Nh is number of holes. So at any particular temperature, in case of pure semiconductor or impure semiconductor, number of electrons and number of holes, multiplying them, that should be equal to number of charge carriers in the semiconductor. Ni is the number of charge carriers. So this is what, in case of doping, we can increase p-type, or like we can increase number of electrons or number of holes. Now there are few points to be remembered in case of doping, right? Now observe them carefully. First point is that germanium and silicon, they are pure semiconductors. These are pure. And they are tetravalent. Right? So tetravalent means that germanium has 4 valence electrons. Silicon has 4 valence electrons. Now, in order to increase number of electrons or number of holes in this germanium or silicon, you should remember that suppose this is tetravalent, 4 valency. If you are adding another tetravalent, what would happen? 4 electrons in the germanium and 4 electrons in the impurities both get sharing with each other. As a result, a covalent bond is being formed. Number of electrons and number of holes again will be remain same. So therefore, in order to increase number of electrons or number of holes, same valency elements should not be added. That is point number one. Same valency elements should not be doped. Okay, so that is point number one to be remembered. Next step. So what would happen if you are doping same valency element? If you are doping same valency element, all the 4 electrons in the pure and all the 4 electrons in the impure semiconductors, impurities, both, all the 4 share with 4 other electrons which are being added. So therefore, again, number of electrons and number of holes, they will be balanced. There will be no increase in the carrier concentration. So that is what, therefore, you should either add trivalent or pentavalent. Trivalent or pentavalent should be doped. And those impurities which we are doping, they are called as dopants. Trivalent. Why we are using trivalent? If you are adding a trivalent to germanium, like for example, we have germanium and there are 4 electrons. If you are taking a trivalent can be gallium, where there are only 3 electrons. This and this share bonding with each other. This and this share bonding with each other. This and this share bonding with each other. And this electron which is remained, it is excess. So if you are adding a trivalent to germanium, one electron is additionally excess. Each gallium atom which you are adding will increase one excess electron. Therefore, when you are adding a gallium into germanium, one electron is remained free without participating in the bonding. Right? That is first point. And second point, if you are adding a phosphorus, for example, you are taking phosphorus. For phosphorus, there are 5 valence electrons. Phosphorus, antimony, there are 5 valence electrons. Now, this phosphorus will be sharing its bond. This phosphorus will be sharing its bond with germanium. This phosphorus shares one electron and this phosphorus shares the other electron. And here there is one excess electron. So this excess electron, when you are adding a pentavalent or trivalent, the valency number is being different. That is the reason why, in order to increase the impurities, definitely we should add a dopant such that they are trivalent or pentavalent. Okay. So when you are adding a trivalent or pentavalent dopants to a pure semiconductor, definitely there will be electron number and hole number changed. That's second point to be noted. Coming to the third point, look here. The dopants, size of atom or size of dopant atoms should be comparable with size of pure semiconductor atoms. Okay, for example, you have germanium, which is tetravalent. Okay, for this tetravalent, you can add an impurity which is having greater valency, still more valency number, greater valency atomic number, greater valency atom can be added to germanium. But what would happen in such case? The size of pure semiconductor and the size of dopant. So usually the size of atom will be in the order of 10 power minus 10 or 1 angstrom. Okay. So when you are doping a semiconductor, the dopant also should have a size whose value is near to 1 angstrom. It can be 9.9 or it can be 1.1 or 1.2. If size of the dopant atom is greater, for example, if the size of dopant atom is 1.5 angstrom, that cannot sit in pure semiconductor. It cannot accommodate a proper space, proper place in case of a pure semiconductor. If size is varied, then in such cases, the properties, atomic properties would undergo change. Therefore, point number three, which you should remember is, size of the dopant atoms should be comparable with the size of the host atoms. Host is pure semiconductor. Guest is a dopant. Host and guest. Host is pure semiconductor. Guest is dopants. So therefore, the size of host and guest should be comparable with each other. Then only doping will be, doping can increase the electron number or hole number without actually changing the characteristics of the semiconductor. That's point number three to be noted. And the last, it is point number four. The last one. Point number four is that, see, if you are increasing, why we are adding dopants? In order to increase conductivity. If the doping percentage is increased, the conductivity percentage can be increased. That is fair enough. So you have germanium, 100 germanium atoms are there. For 100 germanium atoms, you need to just add only 4 gallium atom or 4 silicon, not more than that. Suppose, like, if you are adding the impurities, what would happen? Conductivity increases. That is fair. But if you are adding the desirable, more than the desirable percentage of impurities, the actual properties of semiconductor would undergo change. So actual properties would undergo change. Therefore, it will no longer be a semiconductor. It will change its properties. So therefore, remember that the doping percentage should be only 4 ppm. 4 ppm is 4 parts per million. Only 4 parts of the millionth part of the host atom should be doped. 4 ppm mean 4 parts per million. Only 4 parts of the millionth part should be added as dopants, so that the original characteristics of the pure semiconductor will remain as it is. Only the electron number or hole number will be varied. So these are important points to be noted when you are doping a pure semiconductor with dopants.